伙伴问我不发面能不能做面包，嘿，我找了个海外华人用英文教做葱花饼的视频，小伙伴学得很开心，我呢好像明白了为什么海外的中餐总是有点怪怪的。原材料两杯面粉、橄榄油，对了，不是花生油，而且面粉用的是两杯，没说多大的杯，做西餐的有惯用的杯，不用说多大。大葱没毛病，温水没毛病，热水和面没毛病，还有这个，别担心，这面和起来就应该是黏糊糊的，好贴心的提醒，醒面20分钟，没毛病。字面意思是，让面休息20分钟，盖上湿毛巾。传统的做法，我送你，不是包上保鲜膜哦。醒面的同时切葱，现在是4根葱，又是温馨提示，暖暖的。刚才的面够做2张饼，那就用2根葱，先把葱竖着切开，再切碎，整个过程大概要1小时。葱切好了，过15分钟再来看看面，揉面，揉个3到5分钟，揉成光滑的球。不错嘛，真的是个光滑的球，再放回去，盖上湿毛巾，第二次休息，要30分钟哦。现在这个面团很漂亮，很放松。再次揉面，要在案板上加面粉哦。面团切成2半，给另一半盖上毛巾，另一半保湿。这个要擀出来，擀成12平方英寸吧。对，12平方英寸，海外的小伙伴都明白。撒上橄榄油，字面意思是给它打扮一下，我用的是橄榄油。也有人用芝麻油，哎，请问用香油做葱花饼的小伙伴举个手。我就是偏爱橄榄油，饼上撒盐，这就让我想起外国小伙伴做披萨了。我是把调料跟葱花放到碗里拌匀了，再铺到饼上，再撒上葱花，卷起来，稍微压平一点，捏住2头，封住油和葱花，再卷成蜗牛的形状，一层层的，像个可颂或者千层酥。这个阿姨可真是好努力的，让外国朋友理解葱花饼。最后把一头塞到下边，手掌压平，撒上面粉，再次擀开，擀到你的煎锅那么大。也对，国外很少有咱们国内常见的饼铛，煎锅预热，预热到中等热度就准备开烙吧。同样流程，跟第二团面走一波。这是阿姨的温馨提示，又来一波。撒油，准备烙。好吧，这个英文字幕是自动加的，变音失误。阿姨说的是 with a pancake inside， 饼放进去，盖上盖子，烙2到3分钟，一定会香香的。现在检查一下，阿姨说的对，要有信心，时刻鼓励自己。要翻面了，刚才那面真不错，盖盖再烙2到3分钟，盖盖再烙2到3分钟，检查另一面。哎，这就6到9分钟了，是阿姨的火小，还是爱吃干的硬的胡气儿大的呢？行吧，这个英文字幕又出错了。阿姨说的是 Continue to let it cook, brush some oil on the side， 继续烙，刷点油，看你的时间，反正是要把饼烙出漂亮的棕色，还要动动锅，均匀受热。 阿姨确实是动了动锅，不是单纯的动锅里的饼。阿姨强调一定要起酥，要有棕色的斑点儿，漂亮的棕色斑点，满满的一面。阿姨开始展示饼的亮丽之处了，漂亮，酥脆，看看边上，漂亮，好多层，切开吧，切八份，切起来嘎嘎脆，吃吧您嘞。
Hi, I'm Nancy. Welcome to my kitchen. Today I'm going to show you how to make a savory Chinese snack, scallion pancakes. It's not like the Western pancakes you think of made with the batter, but this is an unleavened flatbread folded in with oil and green onions, and it's simply delicious. So let's get started.Okay, so making these scallion pancakes only require 5 ingredients. I have 2 cups of flour, olive oil, there's salt, scallions, and warm water here. So let's begin with making the hot water dough. So we're going to mix the warm water in with the flour. It's going to take a minute. And what this does is the warm water cooks the dough a little bit and it limits the gluten development and it helps make the dough easy and smoother to work with. So we're going to continue working the water into the dough and it's shaping up. And don't worry, it's supposed to be a little tacky.I'm going to add a little bit of flour here. And then I'm going to let this rest for 20 minutes and cover it with a damp towel. So in the meantime, let's cut the scallions. I have 4 sprigs here. The dough we're making is going to be enough for 2 pancakes. So I intend on using 2 sprigs for each pancake. We'll split the onions in half. And then we're going to mince it up finely. Now, this whole process will probably take an hour. And you're going to have really tasty scallion pancakes. You'll be glad you learned how to do it. You can make these up anytime.Okay, so let's check back in 15 minutes after the dough has rested. Flour your work surface. Now we're going to knead the dough for about 3 to 5 minutes until it turns into a smooth ball. This is a good workout. That looks really good. It's a smooth ball. So let's put it back in the bowl and cover with a damp towel and let it rest a second time for 20 to 30 minutes. Now the dough is nice and relaxed. Let's roll it out. Put some flour on your work surface. We're just going to cut it in half.Cover the other half with a towel to keep it moist, not to dry out. So we're going to roll this out to maybe a 12-inch square. This looks pretty good, actually. So we're going to add, I'm using olive oil. You'll find some recipes, they use sesame oil. I've tried that, and I have a preference for olive oil. Plus, you know, I get to get my omega-3s. But, you know, there's 2 pancakes, so I would encourage you to try one using olive oil and one using sesame seed oil, and see which one you like better.Let's sprinkle some salt. I'm going to add green onions. Like lots of green onions. That looks pretty good. So now what we're going to do is roll it from the bottom up. And roll it up like a jelly roll. And it's going to roll fairly easy. The dough is really easy to work with. And then at the top, just flatten it out a little bit. And pinch the ends to seal the oil and the onions. And now we're going to roll it up. It's like a snail shape. And so what we're trying to do is create layers similar to a croissant or a puff pastry. So the end here, we're going to tuck it underneath.And flatten it with the palm of your hand. Add a little more flour. Now we're going to roll this out. Roll it out to the circumference of your frying pan. Mine is about 9 inches. So anywhere between 8 to 9 inches is good. Okay, so preheat your frying pan to a medium heat. And let's get ready to fry this. And what you're going to do is repeat the same process with your second dough. So now we're going to fry the pancake out of the oil. Leave the pancake inside.And we're going to cover it. Let it cook for about 2 to 3 minutes. We're going to keep the pan covered because the water vapors from the pancake is going to expand and that's going to cause the layers to slightly separate. So that's going to create flakiness and tenderness in the pancakes and it's going to be very delicious. So now let's check the pancake. It's sizzling up quite nicely. I'm going to turn it over. Well, that looks really good. Cover the pan again and let it cook for another 2-3 minutes. That looks really good. Because I used the olive oil,The surface of the pancake has a little tinge of yellow-green color. So let's cover it back up and let it cook for another 2-3 minutes. So let's check the other side. That looks good. Continue to let it cook. To brush a little more oil on the side. You flip it a few times to ensure that the pancake is cooked. It's browning up nicely. And what you also do is move the pan around on your stove to cook it evenly around. I have a hot spot on the far right-hand side of my stove. Flip it over.The smell is really good. You can see the pancake has like a little crusty brown parts, a little mottled. I think it just needs another minute. actually done. I'm just using a chopstick and a spatula to kind of crunch it up on the sides. And it's done. You can remove from the heat. So this is a scallion pancake. As you can tell, it's nice and brown and mottled all over. And if you can see here, it's nice and flaky all around. You see all the edges here. And there's nice layers that are formed. So let's cut it. You just cut it into eighths. You hear the nice crunch? There you go. And here we have scallion pancakes. They're flaky, tender, and simply delicious. I hope you enjoy it. So let's see if Shadow likes it. She's had this before. Oh, I can hear the flakiness, and it's crispy. Oh, she's chomping. I think she likes it. Thank you for watching, all. I hope you enjoyed the recipe. See you next time.